all you gorgeous people. Hope all of you are doing well. So I am here yet again with a new festive glam up look. So let's get started. Here I am prepping my skin using L'Oreal Crystal Micro Essence that will give you a smoother and much glossier skin to put your foundation on. So now here I am moisturizing my skin using Garnier Wrinkle Lift Anti-Aging Cream. It is a really nice cream that gives you a boost of hydration to prep your skin properly, and it is not kind of that chip wala moisturizer. I went ahead and used Color Bar Perfect Match Primer. It's a matte primer that will mattify all your pores if you have any, and also it will help you in sticking your foundation for much longer. I am using the primer on the areas like nose and middle of the forehead, just around your cheeks, and also put some on your neck area. Is very important, do not forget to put primer and foundation on your neck area. Now I am using a local store sponge with my Maybelline Dream Setting Skin Foundation. This is a kind of daily wear foundation that you can wear anytime in daytime or in nighttime because it has a sheer to buildable coverage. Firstly, I made few dots on my face. I took the damp beauty sponge to blend the foundation in all over my face evenly. The idea of using a damp beauty blender is to give you a natural finish, and also foundation does not kick up on your skin and it looks like your skin but better. So here now I am using a dark concealer that is one or two shades darker than my actual skin tone. It is from Swiss Beauty. The shade is Warm Sand. It helps in color correcting if you have any kind of discoloration around your mouth or your under eyes. Then you can use a shade or two darker than your actual skin tone that will remove any kind of discoloration. Then I am just blending. Blending is the key. Like, you have to blend everything that you are putting on your skin, because until and unless you are not blending, it will look cakey. Now I am using a highlighting concealer. It is from Maybelline Fit Me and my shade is Sensible. To highlight my under eyes, because I have a very deep set eyes that looks like I have major dark circles. Now I am using Lakme Sun Expert Ultra Matte Compact to set all of the base that I have already put on. It will fix the base on its place and it does not budge. To set the powder in, I am using a slanted kabuki brush. It is from Miniso. So it will place the powder on the exact areas where I want to. So basically it is under my eyes, over my eyes, around the nose and my forehead, because these are the areas I tend to get more sweaty. Once everything is set in place, I am using this brow powder from Miniso. It has three shades. I am using the dark one in the middle because it matches my hair perfectly. I am using the brush it came with. It has a slanted end, as I said, that will distribute the product evenly onto your brows. Just combing my eyebrows through. Now it's time to bronze. Here I am using Vertebral Contouring Brush. It has a rectangular shape that will help in placing your bronzer or contouring powder. Again I am using Vertebral Mega Glow Contouring Palette. It has two shades. One is to highlight and the other one is your best contouring or bronzing shade if you are near to my skin tone or lighter than me. Now here I am just bronzing whole of the face, because after putting foundation your face started to look kind of flat. See how the correct color of your bronzer can give you a correct warmth that will look like a sun-kissed, you know, skin. If you have double chin like me, then use your contouring and bronzing powder under your jaw. It will help you in chiseling your face structure, you know. will the jawline would be more defined if you are using bronzing powder under your jawline. Then see, you need to drag the bronzing powder down too. It is not creating a line on your face, it is just blending all of the thing together and make it look one. Bronzing up my forehead, bronzing up my jawline to make it look slimmer than I don't have. Now I am just going ahead with whatever left in my brush and slightly contouring my nose, because I don't have a big nose but I need it also to be chiseled and in, you know, mixed with all of the face so that it does not look left out or kind of pale. You need to blend in the contour to your eyebrows. See, this is the way I like to do my nose contouring. Generally, I don't do it. But if I'm going for a glammed up look, then I would do only this way. Nothing much, just contouring my lower lip area to make it look more fuller. Just checking out whatever the things are looking and if I need to blend something. So I just took a flat kabuki brush to blend everything in if I have any harsh lines. So it will help in removing all of them and make it look seamless and blended. So that nobody can tell where the contouring is starting or ending. Now here again I'm taking my damp beauty sponge, just cleaning out the edges of the contouring and bronzing that I did. Will make your jaws look cleaner, not muddy. Again, I'm going to blend the powder that I put between my contouring and the highlight on my jaw. So blending, as I said, is the key. Now I picked up my favorite blush. It's from L'Oreal and the shade name is Life is a Peach. Applying it on my apples of the cheeks and around the bronzing that I did, it should be in a mix with each other. There should not be any harsh line, as I earlier said. So here I'm just mixing my blush with the bronzing and again putting some on the nose. It will make you look, you know, fresh and younger. So here I'm using the highlighter. It's again from Maybelline. Shade name is Molten Rose Gold. See how it's beaming on my forehead. So it's on you how much you want to put on your face. Again, just highlighting the usual areas on the forehead, the cheekbone, nose, bridge of the nose, tip of the nose, and a cupid's bow. Here I am using nude pencil from Battle Wild. Name is Calling Your Buff. It is a nice nude pencil. Using a nude pencil will make your eyes look even opened and wake. I'm just using a trick to apply any crayon of any kind of color that you like on your eyelids, and you need to just put some on your lid and just blend in using your fingers. See, it will give you a flush of color with a soft glam that I'm going today for. It's not anything very much hyped and complex, and you can use this trick if you don't have any kind of eyeshadow, or anyone can use this trick to just give your eyes some color. Again, I am using a kajal pencil from Nykaa. It's called Nykaa Glamorize. The shade is Moonchild. My god, you guys, this is so pigmented. See, you will get the pigment in one stroke. I kid you not, when I just swatched it on my eyes, I was just shook. So here we are done with the eyes. Now I'm just using Maybelline mascara or Lash Sensational. It will give you a fuller look and also it will help you in making your eyes look big, because I don't have big eyes, so I really crave for it. Applying the same on my lower lashes. Just figuring out what shade to wear and what will match with my this eye look. So here I got one. This is a liner from NYX. It's completely ripped off because I use it a lot, that you can see. I have been using it since I don't know how many months. I'm just outlining my lips following my natural lip line. Again, I picked up a Maybelline lipstick. It's from Maybelline's Creamy Matte range and the name is Lust for Blush. So it's all about blushes today. I'm just applying it all over my lip. Once I am happy with the way my makeup looks and the lipstick I applied is completely opaque on my lips, then I went ahead and used this Flower Beauty Seal the Deal Hydrating Setting Spray. It has a dewy finish and it sets the makeup perfect. Now we are done with the looks. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Please like, share and subscribe to my channel. Bye guys.